Hi, Strands. How are you? I hope you are keeping fine. Welcome back to our chemistry class. We were discussing the physical properties of metals and non-metals in the last class, out of which we already discussed, that is, metals are shiny in appearance and we use the word lustrous, metallic luster, or simply lustrous in nature. Then metals are generally hard, but their hardness change from metal to metal. And third one, malleability. What is malleability? That is, the metals can be hammered into thin sheets, and that ability is called malleability. So we can say metals are malleable in nature. And I think one more property we discussed. What's that? Yeah, conductors. Okay, metals are conductors. To discuss the conductivity of metals, let us discuss an activity here. Activity 4.2. See how to make an electric circuit to test whether electricity can pass through an object or not. You might have done this activity in your grade 6 with various objects. Now here also let us repeat the same activity. Use an iron nail, some wires, a 6 volt battery or simply a battery, and a bulb. Repeat the activity. You can see the diagram from your textbook. The textbook, it is given as an iron nail. Iron nail. While using iron nail, the bulb will glow, no doubt. Why? Because iron nail conduct electricity. Iron nail conduct electricity. Okay, see, repeat the same activity using or iron rod instead of iron nail. And see, let us tabulate the observations. First one, iron rod or nail. What do you observe? Yeah, the glowing of bulb. That is, from the glowing of bulb, let us infer that iron rod or iron nail can act as a good conductor of electricity. Good conductor of electricity. Then just change the iron nail and connect a sulfur rod. Will you see any glowing of bulb? No, the bulb will not glow. So, we can record its nature as poor conductor. Poor conductor. And see, repeat the same activity using coal piece instead of the rolled sulfur. Then, what about the inference? Can you say, will bulb glow? No, the bulb will not glow. So we can infer cold piece is also a poor conductor of electricity. And see, copper wire. What about copper wire? In the case, copper, wire conduct electricity and therefore the bulb will glow. So here we can record it as a good conductor. So in this activity we observed that iron rod, nail and copper wire are good conductors, while rolled sulfur piece and coal piece are poor conductors. Okay, so from this activity, let us classify materials into one which conduct electricity and the other which do not conduct electricity. Okay? Yes. Then, let us discuss another property of metals. Where do you find the use of aluminium or copper wires? Copper wires are always using electric lines. Whereas aluminium wires also in electrical wires. Okay? Yes. Then why these metals are used in electrical purposes? Yeah, that we already studied that they are conductors of electricity. Then, can we use the wires only? Can we use wires only? See, the metals can be drawn into thin wires, and that ability of metals are called ductility. So let us record one more physical property of metals, which is that ductility. So what do you mean by ductility? The ability of a metal which can be drawn into thin wires are called ductility. In short, we can say metals are ductile in nature. So we already discussed some properties like metallic luster, that is shiny appearance. Metals are generally hard in nature. They are malleable. They are good conductors of heat and electricity. And finally, ductility. And let us discuss one more physical properties of metal. Do you see the school bells? Ringing bells are always made up of metals. Why we are using metals only there? Why? Yeah, that is, if there is any striking, it will produce sound. So metals that produce sound on striking or ringing sound simply are called sonorous. What's the word? Sonorous. Okay. So sonorous means metals are able to produce sound while striking is called sonority. The ability of metals to produce sound is called sonority. So in short, we can say metals are sonorous in nature. Metals are sonorous in nature. And see, have you ever noticed the difference in the sound on dropping an iron sheet or iron plate or a metal coin and a piece of coal on the floor? In the case of iron sheet or iron plate or a metal coin, there will be a ringing sound. But can you see Any sound during cold breeze? No, or not at all. So here, metals are sonorous in nature. That is, they will produce sound while striking. And see, here we discussed the sonority of metals. So metals are said to be sonorous in nature. So after performing these much activities, we can say that some materials are shiny, hard, malleable, conductors of heat and electricity, ductile, and sonorous. So the materials possessing these characteristic properties are called metals. So we can classify these materials as metals according to their physical properties. So we can notice the points of or the physical properties of metals like lustrous, hard, malleable, conductors of heat and electricity, ductile, and sonorous. As we know, can you say some examples for metals? Yes, then say iron, very good. Next one, aluminium, then copper, then calcium. Okay. So these are examples for metals. And see, in contrast, some other materials also there. That is, they are dull in appearance. And while striking, will they produce sound? No. Then by hammering, what about the nature? Can we make them sheet? No, they will powder by hammering. And see, what about their conductivity? Are they good conductors or poor conductors? Yes, they are poor conductors of heat and electricity. So the materials having that type of properties can be grouped into non-metals. Non-metals. So metals and non-metals. Okay? Yes. Can you give examples for non-metals? Sulfur, very good. Then coal or carbon, then nitrogen, then oxygen, etc. are examples for non-metals. And see, while discussing the property, that is the hardness of metals, did you notice that I told you the hardness changed from metal to metal? Then why did we express like that? So what about, is there any soft metals? Yeah, no doubt. Some exceptional metals are also there. For example, lithium, sodium, potassium are soft metals. Are soft metals. That is, they can be cut with a knife. They are so soft to cut with a knife. Okay? Yes. Then, metals are solids in nature. That we know. Metals are solids in nature. Here also, one exception is there. One metal that exists as liquid. Can you say the name? Yeah, very good. Mercury. So mercury is the only liquid metal. Okay, so these are exceptions. So the main physical properties of metals are, metals are lustrous, they are generally hard, they are malleable, they are good conductors of heat and electricity, they are ductile, and they produce sound on striking, and is called sonorous. Okay, and some exceptions from material particles like from metals as lithium, sodium, potassium are soft metals and they can be cut with a knife. And a metal that exists in liquid form is mercury. Okay, students? Do you get me? Okay, thank you.